What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Python Image Library Module Tutorial Series. We're going to be moving on. In the last video, we were looking at image ops and image operations. Now we're going to check out Image Enhance. Now, Image Enhance is kind of nice. It contains a few classes that are used for simple image enhancement. And they all work kind of the same way, so I'm going to wrap it all into just one video here. So, I don't think we actually need this functionality to convert things rather from an RGBA band to an RGB image band, so I'm just going to kill that. If we do get a problem, I mean, hey, we could just rewrite that. But I'm pretty sure the Image Enhance module will work just fine with an RGBA image. So, I mean, without further ado, what you do when you run the Image Enhance module here is you create a class that is either a sharpness enhancer, and all of these will take the image that you're working with as an argument. There's also a color enhancer. There is a brightness enhancer, a contrast enhancer, and those are all of them, actually. Yeah, brightness and contrast. So I'm actually just going to write those here. Brightness, contrast, sharpness, and color. And now every single one of these, when you create them, you're going to want to store them in, for one thing, an object. And I'll just call mine enhancer. So that'll be the... let's go back to sharpness, actually. Sharpness first. And there it is. There's our object that we're going to be able to use our Image Enhance module sharpness class or color class or contrast or brightness class. And what this will do is we'll change the value in the image. So we set it up with actually a factor. The enhancer object, or the object that we created to store the module class, has one function. It's called enhance. And all it does is it takes one factor. And this factor is typically either values from 0.0 to 1.0. I think for some of them it goes to 2.0, and we'll experiment and find out as we move along here. So let's go ahead and run with it. What this does is it returns the image, so we're going to actually set image to equal enhancer.enhance. So I'm going to check it out here. I'm looking at the documentation off on the side here. So, yeah. 0.0 for sharpness is going to return a blurred image. So let's run this. And if I fire up the image here, I don't know if you can really see it all that well, but it is slightly blurred. If we use 1.0, it will return the original image. Now you might be able to see the difference. Actually, I'll leave this open. And 2.0 is going to return an even sharpened image, which you totally can't see. Let's change it with color, because maybe we'll have a little bit more a little bit more visual change there. So this takes in a range from 0.0 and 1.0. 1.0 is going to actually give the original image, and 0.0 is going to turn it black and white. So if we run this, now if I check out, there we go. Hey. Oh, and Apple wants to update. That's cool. Go away. And of course, you can choose any values in between this. 0.5. And you've got a somewhat, like, less colored image. Do the same thing with brightness. Brightness goes from 0.0 to 1.0. I'm pretty sure sharpness is the only one that goes to 2.0. In fact, it is. Alright, so brightness is going to bring it down to, well, empty image, a black image. So, because we've got the alpha channel, it's all transparent. And 1.0 gives it the original image. Let's go to 0.5, see how that looks. Should run the code. And there. And we'll look at, finally, the contrast one. Contrast. Now, contrast adjusts contrast. 0.0 is going to give it a solid gray image. And 1.0 is, of course, the original image, like we've seen in all the other examples. And anything that we use in between is, of course, the in-between. So, okay. So, anyway, that's the Image Enhance module. I don't see too much of a use for it, but I want you guys to know that it exists. And these are the four things you can kind of manipulate and play with by an enhancer object, the simple enhance function, and then a factor value. It's typically a float from 0.0 to 1.0, but if you're using sharpness, you can go all the way up to 2.0. So, okay. I'm thinking I'm done here. That's all I wanted to show you guys. Again, super simple. Probably aren't going to have a whole lot of use for it, but know that it exists. Thanks, guys. I'll see you in the next tutorial.